We're here to talk about the kingdom and try to introduce some ideas of the way the kingdom works. I am 82 years old, and I kind of encountered the Lord when I was 12, so that gives me a little 70-year run. And I don't claim greater authority for that 70 years, but I do claim that I can see some of the issues in a way that hasn't been presented. And I think I can see more clearly through the glass that Paul talked about, that is kind of dark and you can't see the issues like they really should be. At 12, right after I had a serious encounter with the Lord, my mom and dad were divorced, and ugly divorce. And I found myself in the courtroom, and the judge is saying to me, do you want to go with your mother, or do you want to go with your father? Little did I know how sovereign that was, because as I began to understand the kingdom, I began to understand the church's mother and the kingdom's father. And what I want to say is, A, I am a church man, but when I saw that the church had essentially taken Father's credit card and Father's authority, gone off to do her own thing, departing from what I think is basic kingdom governmental issues, all of that came back to me in a very living illustration. I could see, feel, hear the difference between church and kingdom. And so when I met the Lord, I was in the Navy, and I had time to read and really go after this thing. Now, I don't claim to be a research scientist, but I do claim to be able to count. And what I found while I was reading the New Testament on the ship was, kingdom is used 104 times in the four gospels. Church is used 3 times. Suddenly the reality of all that broke over me, and I started a journey to try to understand the kingdom of God, the government of God, and what was all of that? What did Jesus say to people when he proclaimed the kingdom?